Airports serve as a cruel reality to he who's in seclusion. The bustling crowds are just an illusion, a sick reminder of the people he's been losing. This was not my choosing. Today I sit alone, watching, wishing, wondering, waiting, wasting, watching children turn those long moving sidewalks into treadmills, disregarding the directions of the masses, swearing the elders have it all wrong, simply altering the path by changing its direction, little Robbie Frosts in their own right wishing. Wishing one of the children would make it through the stream of people before their legs gave out to the fatigue or their drive gave into the conformity wondering. Wondering why they call this place a terminal if it only serves as a means to go somewhere else waiting. Waiting by folding my boarding pass until the boredom passes, wasting time, wasting paper, just wasting. And it wasn't until today that I realized that I am an airport. I'm not lying, man. Let me diagram my diaphragm. You see, each vein is a moving sidewalk, making sure every blood cell is on course to reach its concourse, whether it's headed for the control tower or the food courts. But this luggage carousel stopped being merry after its last go-round. That'll happen to anyone whose baggage goes unclaimed for as long as mine has. TSA is not hard to find. It's in my brain, looking for flaws that could cause a breach in security. But excessive self-evaluation will only teach insecurity this heart. This heart doubles as a convenience store. Customers content with only skimming through its contents, only asking the checkout clerk for a receipt. Never her name, or what her plans are after work. My hands, they are terminals. For they have moved many people. But no one has ever found lasting comfort in their shelter. There's a front desk in my chest that's of little use these days. Most people just print off their boarding passes in advance. You know, anything to avoid having to check in. And although this airport is operated by an adult now, there is still a child in me. He too runs the wrong way on the moving sidewalks. I can feel him in my veins bumping against blood cells as he goes against the mainstream. Each disruption constitutes my pulse. And some days, when my heartbeat loses its vigor, that child in me will scream, "Can't you see the children? They are all running backwards. Why do we go in circles when we can't sustain the cycle? Life is not a cycle, it's a spiral. Movement does not entail progress. Maybe that is why they call this place a terminal."